is about taking control. It's about taking control of a number of things. One is 350 million a week go to Brussels. Now, it is true that some of that comes back here, but that money which comes back with exact conditions. And it's not decided by us how it's spent, it is decided by the bureaucrats in Brussels. And why is that important? It's important because if I make a decision on how the money is spent, every 5 years, you can kick me out. And people have got a habit of irregular intervals kicking out governments, and that's called democracy. The one thing you cannot do is actually kick out that mechanism in Brussels which makes those decisions. The second thing you regain control over is your borders. And to me, controlling your borders is at the heart of the function of the nation state. Now, you will come across things where people say, oh, we've opted out of Schengen. No, we haven't gotten it. Another big thing which happened in the 90s, which people forget about, was the creation of something called European citizenship. Now, looking around here without wishing to be rude, a fair number of you remember passports which were of a different colour. And then when they all turned purple, that's when they became European citizenship. And with that, it meant that over 500 million people had the right to come and travel and work across Europe. And whilst we can ask them to show the passport, we cannot determine who comes in and comes out. And the reason why that is important, and you know, as an immigrant myself, I know immigration has happened before the European Union, will go on after the European Union, and has actually been enormously beneficial to most countries because of the movement of people. But it needs to be managed, it needs to be controlled. We need to have a handle on this. In the West Midlands, we are now short of 50,000 primary school places. We've got the worst A&E waiting figures. We have got very low social housing provisions. That means that our public services are under pressure because the process is not managed. That is a real difficulty. We also now got a situation where the European courts tell us who we can deport, who we cannot deport. Some people who we'd like to not allow in, we're not allowed to come in. So it's about regaining control over decision making. And at the heart of that, it means regaining control over your politicians who make decisions about you. Because there's one thing, you know, I was born in Germany in the mid-50s. I remember 1966, and you can argue that this one as well. And I came during something called the three-day week. And you know, for those of you who remember, this country was in a bit of a trouble, to call it politely, and Europe was the place where it was glitzy and the economic miracle, and this is where things were happening. And I can't understand where 1972, 73, joining what was then the common market seemed really the forward-looking thing to do. But the common market has changed, but also the world has changed. And the big things about the world have changed is globalization. The movement of goods, so it's no longer Brussels tariffs, it's the World Trade Organization, which is by far more important. The movement of capital, which the EU institutions are singularly incapable of controlling. 2008, that big crash was about global flows of money over which we had lost control. And the third thing now is movement of people. You know, you may at the moment not have the daily reports about what's happening on the Greek borders and what's happening in North Africa, but it doesn't mean it has stopped, it is still happening. And just because we are currently telling Turkey to control our European borders is not a solution to the problem. So as far as I'm concerned, 23rd of June is important about the way we are governed. It's important about making us stronger because we take back control of our economic decisions. It's going to make us safer because we're going to take back control of our borders. And I also think it will make us more prosperous because we will focus on trading with those areas of the world which have seen economic growth, not with mainland Europe, which is stagnating in many ways. And I'll just give you one thought. We have traveled today, we've been to a big builders merchant company. They buy all their material from the UK, and they sell all their material within the UK. And yet they are bound by all the European Union regulations. So there is something very liberating about some of the trading arrangements. So I would say to anybody here, take control, vote leave, and make 24th of June Independence Day.